It's that time of the year again. It's time for a Looney Tunes LP. So hey everybody, and welcome to Let's Play Looney Tunes Acme Arsenal. I don't have much to say in this little intro, so let's just kick things off with the story. Oh. Well then, let's just kick things off with the tutorial. Spoiler alert, this is like the worst tutorial in the history of video games. Well, no, I'm sure I've had worse tutorials, but this one, it leaves a little something to be desired. So yes, this is Looney Tunes Acme Arsenal, and it's... Okay, that was very weird. I have no clue what Bugs was doing. But yeah, this is a little bit different from the previous Looney Tunes games I LP'd. Whereas Lost in Time and Time Busters were 3D platformers and Sheep Raider was a stealth puzzler, this is a beat-em-up. It'll put you in the mind of God of War, only nowhere near as good. But it's alright in its own right, I guess. So why are you doing random attacks, Bugs? Yeah, square to attack, circle to spin. I don't know why. Is my circle button stuck? No? Okay. And then you have triangle for a little up attack. I think they wanted me to do... Okay, never mind. I don't know. This tutorial doesn't tell you anything. You just do the commands that show up over his head. You can chain things together in the combos too, but eh. You know, just randomly striking everything seems to work as well. Like I said, God of War, this is not. So yeah, you know, press square 3 times and then press circle to do the little finishing thing. Whatever. Yeah, the controls, not the greatest, but hey, they try. Oh, square, square, triangle, that's a pretty good one. All right, square, square, X, triangle, there we go. All right, he's dead. Okay, we're doing good. So now we need to get the keys, we need to do what we've learned up until now. You know, use our skills. Our button mashing skills. I mean, that's pretty much all a beat-em-up is. You know, you just mash buttons until everything's dead. Oh no, we have a switch. We must step on it. Oh, and by the way, the guy whose face is on that switch, that's Professor, or is it Doctor? I think it's Doctor. Dr. Frankenbeans. Yeah, I kind of forgot the story of this game. I'm sorry. I will have the story. I feel bad about missing that easy jump. But I have the story ready for you guys at the beginning of the next part. It's not the best story, though. I mean, this game is kind of like, eh. I mean, it's an alright game. I mean, from what portion of it I played, I mean, I gave it like a little test run because this is going to be mostly blind, but yeah, I'm not going to sit here and call it the greatest game, you know, square to activate the switch. I mean, the ratings for this game were like very bad. Oh, and yeah, triangle to interact with stuff. We have a weapon. L2 to lock on. Okay. L2 to lock on. R2 to shoot. Okay. And damn it. Lock on and kill. All right. Good job. But yeah, this game was only released for the Xbox 360, PS2, and Wii. Because this came out during a time when the PS3 wasn't doing too hot. And yeah, that's the end of the tutorial. But like, of all three systems... What the hell is a Ludium? I should have looked in the manual. But yeah, the 360 version was the highest rated. Then came the PS2 version. Then the Wii version. And there are some differences between the versions. The 360 version has online multiplayer and leaderboards and achievements. The Wii version has motion controls, of course. And this game, well, you know, it doesn't have online multiplayer or leaderboards or achievements. I mean, of course not, it's a PS2 game. And of course it doesn't have motion controls, and yeah, we're gonna be playing on normal. But what this game does have, if I can get there in a timely manner, is this a Wile E. Coyote level. And that was the reason why I bought this version. Because I like Wile E. Coyote. He's so underrated. He's a great character. But enough about that. Let's start things off with Whack-Tastic Robot-Bash. Little Green Man with a Plan. That's the name of this little string of missions. Like I said, I gotta refresh myself on what the story is, because it is kind of weird. And yeah, we're gonna be tossed right to the action, so you're gonna have to kind of, you know, figure out what's going on. Yeah, there's a lot of time travel in this game, and different Looney Tunes characters interacting with each other. It's weird, but you'll see what I'm talking about. Anyway, Whack-Tastic Robot Bash. Yeah, no, if I had a second player, we could fight over who gets to be Bugs and who gets to be Marvin. But hey, since I'm by myself, I get to switch in between the two. To my recollection, skill sets aren't that different between characters, but eh. Cosmetic changes are always nice.
I knew I should have taken that left turn at Albuquerque.
Of course. Yeah, the animation, it's not that bad, but eh. And considering there was a 7-year gap between Sheep Raider and this, you kind of expect a little bit better. But to be fair, this game wasn't done by Infogrames.
Okay, Mac, start pounding.
And Taz randomly shooting Marvin the Martian somewhere is how we kick things off. I don't know. Let's just go with it. Also, this game is really dark. And I don't mean content-wise, I mean visually, this game is freaking dark. I am playing with all the lights on in my room right now. Cause, yeah, the way I sit, the screen is already dark, but holy crap. Alright, so, we just need to kill robots and collect coins. We cannot go through there, so we must take the shortcut. This is the longest shortcut I've ever seen in all my days. Alright. Yeah, we gotta collect all these things. No, damn you, robot! Okay, what are robots doing in a medieval freaking castle anyway? It doesn't make sense! And again, Looney Tunes doesn't really make sense in its own right. I mean, you have talking anthropomorphic animals, and we can switch to a alien that's obsessed with killing everybody, I guess. Oh yeah, we got a little archer right here. He's easy to deal with. Alrighty. My god, this is so freaking dark! I'm not over that yet! Alright, we reached a checkpoint. Damn you! Robots! And yeah, you're gonna hear a lot of button clacking. It's a beat-em-up. You expect that. Crap. Okay. Damn you! Die! Thank you. He died of... Ooh, I almost had a little catastrophe there. Oh, and the characters don't share health meters, so if things are getting a little hairy for Bugs, I can always press L1 to switch to Marvin. I like his running animation, though. Why does that always happen? For some reason, they just randomly switch. Yeah, I think something might be wrong with my controller. I will look into that. I will definitely look into that. Too bad I don't have a spare... Actually, I think I do have a spare controller. Oh, but it's a third-party piece of shit. Yeah, whatever. I might have to bite the bullet and use it until I can get another, official PS2 controller. But enough about the tech issues. I mean, I don't know, this game was giving me a few tech issues earlier. I had to switch PS2s to record this, because for some reason it was not doing so hot on my, like, main PS2. Well, I say main, but I think I switched into that one for some reason. I don't know. Whatever. If this archer can die, that would make me very happy. Because I think I need to beat him to move on. Okay, you know what, Archer? Getting real tired of your shit. Archer! Oh my god! Truly, I have met my greatest foe! the cowardly archer. Well, actually, no, he's not really cowardly. I mean, archers would more than likely do this in real life. You know, they need to have be far away to have a proper vantage point to strike you with their arrows. But he is now... he was close to be... Okay, you know what? Oh my god! Thank you! Wow. Truly. Truly, that archer was a worthy foe. By worthy foe, I mean he ran. He ran his ass off. But I eventually beat him. So dark. I can't tell what is wall and what is bottomless pit. Oh, man. And this game has no brightness settings. Trust me, I looked in the options. There are no brightness settings. Just sound options, I believe. I can't remember. Like, there's a whole freaking options menu, but there's only one thing in there. And actually, no, I think it's just controls. It's weird. Yeah, we're just getting sidetracked because I want as many coins as I can get. You use coins to buy weapons, as you saw in the tutorial, but you can also use them to buy other things, too. Other useful things. We're just gonna leave that lone archer standing right there. He's minding his own archer business, so... No, I'm not gonna waste time jumping over there to kill him. But any other given day, I would've. Because I don't like archers like that, taking the cowardly way out, finding an awesome vantage point and just sniping me from there. Oh, this archer, he got the moves. Too bad he's about to die once I take care of these guys. My accuracy, tis off. Tis very off. Archer, getting real sick of you. Oh, and plus, I think when you fill up that green meter, you get a little bit stronger. I kind of feel sad that I'm talking over their, well, not their, but Marvin's one-liners, but, eh. Oh, he doesn't use his fist, he uses a lightsaber. Oh, alright, go on with your bad self, Marvin. Don't know why it took me that long to notice that. Don't know why it's taking me this long to kill this archer. Oh my god. Damn you, archer. Thank you. Holy crap! These archers, man! Alright, moment of truth. This is where the game was crapping out for me before. On my other PS2. Actually, no, it was a little bit further. Never mind. We still have some time. Explosions! Michael Bay would be proud.
Oh no.
Oh wow, things are not looking too good for your health there, Marvin. Okay, come on. Get your Darth Maul. Okay, you know what? We're switching to bugs. No, no need to apologize, Marvin. You tried your best. Have no regrets. All right. Where to? Seriously, where to? Oh, we got a weapon, but this weapon sucks. Because it punches. I don't like that. I want this weapon. I probably should have got that weapon first before I fought those guys. Marvin would have probably had a better chance, but eh. Whatevs. Whatevs. Yeah, you don't want to waste ammo, you know, just shooting the things. Blah. Detour. Oh my god, I can jump up here. I feel really stupid. In the past, I was just doing insane parkour shenanigans to get up here. Curse the darkness of this screen. Curse these enemies not dying from my gun. Bugs locking on to the wrong places. I'm already out of ammo. But yeah, that's how you better deal with the archers, I guess. I'm sorry, but what? Oh, there is a pit right there. Oh, okay. But yeah, what I was doing before was like parkouring my way up to that little place over there and jumping up here. Like jumping over here. Do I want to go up here? Do I dare traverse up top? And ain't worth it. Alright, is it alright for me to switch back to Bugs now? Oh no, I'm stuck with Marvin! Who is like an inch away from death. Hopefully, I'm nearing a checkpoint. Okay, I thought I jumped there, apparently not. Alright, come on. Do not let them kill you, Marvin! You have come too far! Okay. Screw it, I will take care of this. These archers. Oh, no. Yep. Yeah, something's wrong. Something is wrong here. Something is definitely wrong. It can't be the disc. This is like a brand new unopened game. Okay, I'm not going to go over into that alcove because that's where all of my discrete error problems occurred. That little alcove with those three archers. Because now things are going perfectly. I don't know why. I'm just going to accept it. I'm just going to accept it and hope nothing else goes wrong with this game. Okay, I'm kind of on edge now. I'm kind of on edge. But if need be, I will go ahead and buy another copy of this. It's not the most expensive game in the world, and considering it's an old PS2 game and Wii game, you know, it's not gonna be that expensive. Where do I go? It's too dark. Down here? Okay. Damn you, Archer! Also, to get back up here, I did not use Marvin at all, and I kind of skipped over some enemies too, so yeah, they're not gonna be at their full potential. Well, Bugs is kind of OP right now, but yeah, let's just wait. I can barely see these things moving. Oh god. Oh wow. Oh no, not today. My archer pals, you were kind of glitched in place. I should not have hit you out of your little pose. Oh, and there are some slight differences. I noticed that Bugs has a higher jump than Marvin. So there's that. Are you a good weapon? I hope so. And I cannot afford these things. Ah, well. Where's something for me to shoot? There they are. The hell is this, a sniper rifle? Oh, it's I'm shooting flubber at them. I was shooting flubber. That's interesting. Okay then. I guess it was effective. Oh no. What are you? Please die. Oh, see, when you ask for things to die nicely, they tend to do so. A little politeness goes a long way, folks. A little politeness goes a long way. And are we done with the level? We are done with the level. Kind of a bad first part considering, well, at least in this go around, there was no response. Oh, ho, ho, ho. 54 coins, 30 eludium. My score is 35. Does this mean I killed 35 enemies? I don't know! But, yeah, one disc read error. Oh, well, later, we're done with that level. I probably should have used Marvin a little. You know what? To make it up to him, I'll use him in the next part. But at least I can save now! Yes, overwrite that shit. Okay. So we're past that little slippery slope with the discrete error. Hopefully things will go a lot better in the next video. So next time we're going to be taking on a Plantastic Voyage and the Log Ness Monster. Ooh. And this little green man with a plan mission tree thing. I don't know. This game is just set up so weird with its story mode. It's kind of ridiculous. And I don't know why the bonus content is right here when there's still like 60% of the game left after that. And I'm just so mesmerized by that name, In Denial. That's like the greatest level name ever. Fair enough, too. Yeah. Martian Fashion Explosion. I guess that means we're going to be getting some more Marvin later on. Great Eggscape. I see what they did there. Full Metal Omelet. And Wacky Land, the Dodo Bird. He is an underrated Looney Tunes character. I like the Dodo Bird. Even though he was only in, what, 2-3 episodes? He's still great to me, damn it. But alright, enough rambling. Thank you all for watching and see you next time for some more Looney Tunes Acme Arsenal. Oh boy, here's hoping we're past the glitches. Well, can't really say glitch, but, you know, hardware issues. Alright, goodbye.